Okay, so here is an example of a homemade putter. I used the cardboard and I cut out at an angle, as you can see. So the blade was going to be down here, and then there's the angle of basically the shaft of your club. Okay, so it's not a right angle. And then you need some duct tape, some scissors, or a straight edge to cut the cardboard. I used a broom handle, this blue broom handle, and that I just took the broom end off, and I taped the cardboard up the handle, and then I doubled the blade and taped it together so it's a little bit more sturdy. So make sure that if you're a right-hander, that the broom handle's on the correct side of the blade. You don't want that on the hitting side. And as you can see, it definitely works. It might not give you as much force as you would need. All kinds of work, but for sure would work just on the flat surface. Hey PE kids, it's Coach Hall, and I'm going to show you my putt-putt golf hole that I have constructed up in the loft of my house. Okay, so let me show you what we've got going on here. So this is the start right here. You can shoot from in front of the tape, and it's going to follow the duct tape, and then it's going to hit this piece of cardboard, which is a ramp because it's propped up against a chair, and it's going to go up the ramp, and if it goes really high it'll hit the floor mat of my car, and then I've got the shot back hose situated so the ball goes around it, hopefully, that's the idea, comes back down the other side, onto the cardboard, around the hose, and into the hole. That's what we got going on.